Math 1, Unit 9, Modeling Data. Knowing mathematics is like wearing a pair of X-ray specs that reveal hidden structures underneath the messy and chaotic surface of the world. As you start this unit, use this quote to help you reflect on how you can find patterns and make sense of complex problems. The big ideas for this unit involve one variable and two variable data. With one variable data, you will use technology to create box plots and histograms so that you can compare the shape, center, and spread of data sets. With two variable data, you will create scatter plots and then fit a function to the data. You'll use residuals and correlation coefficients to analyze the fit of linear functions and use the functions to solve problems. In the first three lessons of the unit, you will represent one variable data with box plots and histograms. You'll describe data distributions and calculate the mean, median, standard deviation, and interquartile range of the data. You'll interpret these measures of center and spread in context and use these measures of center and spread to compare data sets. You'll determine if the data set contains outliers and examine the effect an outlier has on the shape, center, and spread of a data distribution. With two variable statistics, you will create scatter plots to represent a data set. After creating a scatter plot, you will use technology to create a regression model to fit a function to the data, and then use the model to answer questions and solve problems. With linear data, you will analyze the fit of a function by analyzing the correlation coefficient. You will be able to use the value of the correlation coefficient to determine the strength and direction of a linear relationship. You'll also analyze the fit of a linear function by calculating residuals and creating a residual plot. You'll learn how to look for patterns in a residual plot to determine if your data is best modeled with a linear or nonlinear function. Here is a list of key vocabulary terms for this unit. Some of these vocabulary terms should already be familiar to you from previous courses. Here are some key skills needed to be successful with the content of this unit. You should be able to display numerical data on line plots, dot plots, and histograms, calculate the mean, median, and interquartile range of a data set, construct and interpret scatter plots for two variable data and describe patterns of association, informally fit a straight line and assess the model fit by judging the closeness of the data to the line, and interpret the slope and y-intercept of a linear model in context. In addition to your teacher and school-based resources, there are several additional resources available. The Ready, Set, Go homework help videos are housed in the Canvas site for your class. You may access these in Canvas using your student login. If you do not know how to log into Canvas, ask your teacher for help. The K-12 Math Resource website, which can be found on your school's website, includes additional support items such as unit and lesson overviews, videos overviewing the task, essential vocabulary, the North Carolina standards for each unit, learning targets for each lesson, and extra practice problems.